Thank you. Veronica, you'll be right about here, if that's okay.
Please, your eyes. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
In the waters of baptism, Robert died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May he now share with him eternal glory.
baptism, Robert received the sign of the cross. May he now share in Christ's victory over sin and death. Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Robert, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him. Lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Be seated for our first reading.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will provide for all peoples. On this mountain, he will destroy the veil that veils all peoples. The web that is woven over all the nations, he will destroy death forever. The Lord God will wipe away the tears from all the faces. The reproach of his people he will remove for the whole earth, for the Lord has spoken. On that day it will be said, behold our God, to whom we've looked to save us. This is the Lord for whom we've looked. Let us rejoice and be glad that he has saved us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The responsorial song, the response is, the Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In verdant pastures he gives me repose. Beside restful waters he leads me, he refreshes my soul.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
He guides me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil. For you are my side with your rod and your staff that give me courage. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. You spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Only goodness and kindness follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, are you unaware that we who are baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in the newness of life. For if we have grown into union with him through a death like his, we shall also be united with him in the resurrection. We know that our old self was crucified with him, so that our sinful body might be done away with, that we might no longer be in slavery to sin, for a dead person has been absolved from sin. If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ raised from the dead dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Oh, A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. At noon, darkness came over the whole land until 3 p.m, and at 3 o'clock, Jesus cried out in a loud voice, "Eloi, Eloi, lema sabachthani," which is translated, my God, why have you forsaken me?" Some of the bystanders who heard it said, "Look, he is calling Elijah." One of them ran, soaked a sponge with wine, put it on a reed, and gave it to him to drink, saying, "Wait, let us see if Elijah comes to take him down." Jesus gave a loud cry and breathed his last. The veil of the sanctuary was torn in two from top to bottom. When the centurion who stood facing him saw how he breathed his last, he said, "Truly this man was the Son of God." When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James, and Salome bought spices so that they might go and anoint him. Very early, when the sun had risen, on the first day of the week, they came to the tomb. They were saying to one another, "Who will roll back the stone for us from the entrance to the tomb?" When they looked up, they saw that the stone had been rolled back. It was very large. On entering the tomb, they saw a young man sitting on the right side, clothed in a white robe, and they were utterly amazed. He said to them, "Do not be amazed. You seek Jesus of Nazareth, the crucified. He has been raised. He is not here. Behold, the place where they laid him." The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. Well, to all of the dear friends and family of Robert, and on behalf of Father Christie and the entire St. Agnes Parish family, I want to offer my deepest condolences to each one of you. We know, of course, that it is never easy to say goodbye to somebody whom we so dearly love. This man was your father, your uncle, your friend, your cousin. And at the times when we say goodbye to somebody like this, we of course remember all the many memories we had with the deceased, the good, the bad, and everything in between. And there's always great sadness in saying goodbye to somebody whom we loved so much and who loved us so much. But we as the Christian faithful, we remember that death is not the end. In the gospel that we read today, we read about the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead. This event in history is what changes everything. The fact that Jesus of Nazareth rose from the dead. Because we know that the Lord Jesus is the victor over sin and death. We know, of course, that death is the great equalizer. It's something that comes to all of us. It's something that not a single one of us is able to avoid. Whether you're rich or poor, we know that death conquers us all. And that's why, of course, there's great grief when somebody whom we love dies. Because it seems to be the end. But then we remember that our Lord Jesus Christ rose from the dead and conquered sin and death for us. That is, of course, why there was great rejoicing among these three women who showed up at his tomb. When they saw the angels who said, "You seek Jesus, he is not here, he has been raised." And of course, we as the Christian faithful remember what Jesus said about the resurrection from the dead. He said, "I am the resurrection and the life." And he promised to the faithful that he would raise them to the resurrection of life. This is actually something that St. Paul talks about in his first letter to the Thessalonians. He says, I do not want you to be unaware, brothers and sisters, of the resurrection of the dead, so that you may not grieve like the rest who have no hope. Because what St. Paul is talking about is something that was radically different for his time. The belief in the resurrection of the dead is not something that is shared by other religions. Remember, St. Paul wrote to a largely pagan world. And they believed that, you know, the body wouldn't rise again from the dead. They believed that the gods didn't love them. And so they really didn't have a lot of hope. And especially in those who have no faith at all, for them death is just the end, nothing more. But St. Paul says, I do not want you to be unaware of the resurrection of the dead, so that you may not grieve like the rest who have no hope. Because we do have hope in the resurrection of the dead, a sure and a certain hope that our Lord will raise the dead back to life. That is why we come together today in this funeral liturgy, is we come here today to lift Robert to God our Father in prayer, saying, Heavenly Father, please receive him into the kingdom of heaven. We pray that his sins may be forgiven and that he may be received into eternal glory in heaven. That is the greatest thing that we can do for him right now, is to pray for him. As you remember all the good memories that you had with Robert, if ever you wish that there was one more way that you could thank him, the way that you can do that is by praying for his soul. Praying, Almighty God, that he would be received into heaven. Now also at this time, this is a time for us to pray for and support one another, as there is much grief in saying goodbye to him. And so I invite you, each and every one of you, to cling to one another and to pray together and to pray for your father, your grandfather, your cousin, your friend. As we come together as a community of faith, let us remember who that great Lord really is. He is truly the Son of God. Death has no power over him. And to those who are faithful to him, they too will be co-victors over death. So let us strive, of course, to follow the Lord Jesus so that we may follow him into eternity, into the kingdom of heaven. And while we do so, let us pray for our beloved dead, that he too may be received into the kingdom of heaven, where every tear will be wiped away. Amen.
Please stand. God, the Almighty Father, raised Christ, his Son, from the dead. With confidence, we ask him to save all his people, living and dead.
For Robert Murray, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that he may now be admitted to the company of the saints, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our brother who was nourished by the body of Christ, the bread of life, that he may be raised up on the last day, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of our relatives and friends, that they may have the reward of their goodness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the family and the friends of our brother Robert Murray, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord, who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us who are gathered here in faith, that we may be gathered together with all of our loved ones again in God's kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for our departed brothers and sisters. Cleanse them of their sins and grant them the fullness of redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Just started singing number 329 in this left, where charity and love prevail.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, our Lord,
as we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Robert, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever.
Your voices, we pray, join with theirs
in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
Through him and with him and in him, O God.
Please stand. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. At this time, we will have the distribution of Holy Communion. If you are a Catholic who is properly disposed, I invite you to, at this time, come forward for Communion. If not, I invite you to simply come forward and cross your arms in front of your chest.
Song is number 274, the Missalette, One Bread, One Body.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our brother Robert may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Robert in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you have bestowed upon Robert in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help with us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith, until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. In peace, let us take our brother to his place of rest.
Closing hymn is number 260.
Thank you.
It's number one.
Yes.